Hi, welcome to Move with Shari. My name is Shari, this is my partner Elaine, and this is going to be weekend mode. So we're going to do a sort of wind down, mobility movements, and some core work just to get some blood flowing through the weekend. So we're going to start either seated, or if you feel uncomfortable on the floor, feel free to grab a chair. The other option, if you're on the floor and you don't feel totally comfortable, you can always try putting something under your hips, either a block right on the edge of your hips or a towel or a pillow. And you can always opt to kneel on that block as an option. And you can always move the blocks to different levels if you need, you know, a higher support. But I'm going to start on the floor. So the focus here is to get comfortable. If you have a mat, great, maybe a towel, some option for creating some sort of cushion under your knees, because we're going to be on our knees a little bit, and then possibly under your head if you don't like having your head flat on the floor. So start in your seated position. Take a deep breath, inhale, and exhale, drain some tension out. I'm going to take our arms in front. We're going to make fists. And we're going to round those fists in a circle, loosening it up, and then reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Open the hands. So right hand, point those fingers up. Left hand pulls back through that wrist. And then right hand, fingers point down. Pull back through the upper part of the wrist. Now let's switch. Left hand, fingers up. Using that right hand, pull back through those fingers, through that wrist. And then flip them down. Pull back. Great. Release the arms. We're going to do some shoulder rolls to the front. 3. Slow and control. 2. 1. Reverse. 3. 2. 1. We're going to do some hugs to open up the upper body. So open up the arms and then right arm over left. Grab the back of the shoulders. Rock through the body. Look up to the sky. Open the chest. And then roll that chin into your chest. And for a little bit more of an opener, roll the upper body down into the belly button. Pull that stomach in. Sit it up. Release. We're going to switch the arms. Open it up. Left over right, hug it in, grab the shoulders, rock through the body, and look up, chin open, and then roll it in into your chest, and then roll it upper body into the belly button, releasing through the vertebrae. Sit it up, hands down. We're gonna inhale, arms up, open up. And then exhale, we're going to lean over to that right side. So right hand can grab onto the chair or release down to the floor. And you can slowly bend into that elbow to get deeper into that bend over to the right. So the left arm reaches over and then the right arm controls your extension over that side. Staying in this position, reach that left arm away, opening up through the neck. And then back over, get a little bit deeper. Feel free to get the elbow onto the floor if you can. And then release, come back to the middle. Arms up, inhale. Exhale, we're gonna lean it over to the left side. So left hand either goes onto the chair or onto the floor, bending through, and that right arm reaches over. And then try to open up that chest to the ceiling a little bit. Reach that right arm away, staying bent over, opening up through the neck. And then back over to that left side, get a little bit deeper. And then release back to the middle. Great, we're gonna come onto all fours. Feel free to grab towel or fold the mat for some cushion under your knees. All fours position is wrists under your shoulders. Knees under your hips. If you have trouble finding that, you can really lift up and drop it straight down to find that position. We're going to just do some cat cows to open up through the spine. So cat, cow, looking up for that cow. hip up, tip of the tailbone up, and then round it underneath, pulling both ends underneath, core tight, and then look up, both ends reaching up to the sky, and then round it in, pull that stomach in, making room. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale, both ends reaching to the ceiling. Exhale, round it underneath, looking for that belly button. And then release, coming to that middle neutral spine. We're gonna do some hip circles. So with that right knee in that bent position, we're gonna take that knee out to the side to the right, and then behind you, high up, and then underneath. So literally a hip circle through that joint. So to the right, behind, underneath, that's two. To the right, behind, underneath, that's three. Right, behind, underneath, that's four. Right, behind, underneath, that's five. So we're gonna go to reverse. We're gonna go behind, to the right, underneath, that's one. Behind, to the right, underneath, that's two. Behind, to the right, underneath, three. Behind, out, under, four. You got one more. Behind, out, under, that's five. So take a breath. We're gonna do the other side and do what works for you. It doesn't have to be huge. It just has to open up for that hip. So bring it out to the left, behind, underneath, that's one. Left, behind, under, two, left, behind, under, three, left, under, behind, four, left, under, behind, that's five. So in reverse, behind, left, under, one, behind, left, under, two, behind, left, under, three, behind, left, under four, last one, behind, left, under five, take a breath. Awesome, so we're gonna do a little bit of core work. So we've talked about the box plank, which is basically a plank position with bent knees. So here you're still focusing on the upper body engagement, pushing the weight from the floor, active through the fingers, engage that upper body, pull that core in. So just to give you an example of what I mean by a box plank, you just literally lift the knees 1 inch off the floor. They stay low. So options here, if you don't feel comfortable there, you can just work on your core strength by lifting up the arms and doing shoulder taps. Option two, if you want to experiment with the box plank, you can lift and tap or lift and rest. Option three, if you want to just hold the box plank through this 10 count, that is a good way to warm up and get used to that feeling. And then option four is gonna be holding the box plank and doing shoulder taps. So start with what's comfortable for you. They will all work that middle very strongly. So let's start that 10 count. Let's go. 10, 9. 8, 7, slow and controlled. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a breath. Great. So now we're gonna transition from that box plank, which is here, into the down dog. So down dog, hips are gonna reach for the ceiling. Chest is gonna push towards your thighs, active through those hands, through those fingers, pushing your upper body through your shoulders and reaching those heels for the floor, opening up through the back of the legs. Now, if you can't straighten the legs, it is very good to just be in a bent leg position, working towards opening up through the backs of the legs. So you can work from transitioning to the all fours or from the box plank into that down dog. And if you want to go one step further, You can go from the box plank and reach that arm across as an option. So ready? Let's go. Let's warm up that core. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, strong through that upper body, eight, nine, and 10. Awesome. Take a breath. We're going to open up our hips a bit. So let's bring that right foot forward outside of that right hand. Option here if you want to lift that back leg, but you can always keep that knee on the floor with some padding. So right hand behind the ear. We're going to open up those hips. Open side, fold it in, elbow to elbow. Open side, fold it in. You got one more. Open side, fold it in. Great. Now we're going to come down into our side. So on that left side, come down to your elbow. So option one is going to keep that hip on the floor. This is what Elaine's going to be doing, keeping that hip on the floor. She's going to open up like a butterfly, opening up that hip. Actually, it's like a clamshell, and then close it in. So again, opening up that hip and then closing it in like a clamshell. I'm going to be doing a little bit more core work. So lifting the hips, I'm going to open up like that clamshell and then come down. So in this position, you are using, even on the floor, you're using that oblique underneath because you're pushing through that elbow, pushing through that oblique, that side stomach under your body to stay in this position. So stay active, push that elbow against the floor, use that stomach underneath to push through and engage, and let's open up that clamshell. One, two, three, four, and five. Great. So we're going to move one step up here. Elaine is going to lift her hips. This is going to be a modified side plank, and I'm going to be in a full side plank. You can always stay with your hips on the floor. We're going to take that arm up. The right arm goes up, and then we're going to thread it underneath our body. That's one. Then open up, thread it underneath. And remember, keep those hips high, pushing towards the ceiling. And underneath, three, open up, underneath, for four, open up. Last one, underneath for five. And we open up, and we release. Great, come back to the middle. We're gonna work on that left side. So bring that left foot outside of that left hand. Trying to get the ankle underneath the knee. And option to lift that back leg if you'd like. So take that left hand behind your ear and open side. And then fold it in, elbow to elbow. Open side. Fold it in. Open. Fold it. Two more, open. Fold, one more, open, and fold. We're gonna release, we're gonna come down onto that right side. So again, Elaine's gonna be on that elbow, pushing into the floor, pulling through that body underneath, and she's gonna be doing that clamshell, and I'm gonna be doing that raised clamshell. Ready? So we're gonna come up, open it up for one. Open it up for two. Open it up, three. Open four, open five. And then Elaine's gonna lift that hip for a modified side plank. I'm gonna be in that full side plank, left arm goes up, and then we're gonna thread underneath for one, open up. Thread underneath for two, open, hips high. Three, two more, four, one more. Five. Really awesome. We're gonna come sitting on our butts. We're gonna do a tabletop or crab, whatever you want to call it. So hands are gonna be slightly behind the hips, maybe 6 inches, feet are going to be flat on the floor in front of you. So the goal here is to go up into a crab or a tabletop, which means you're going to lift using the glutes, using the butt, squeeze to the ceiling. And the aim here is for the knees and the ankles to be in alignment. So if you just do an experiment, just make sure that you're using that alignment in the legs. So then release, take a breath. Now, so Elaine's going to be doing, using the glute, she's going to squeeze the hips up. And if you don't want to go all the way up, you don't feel like you're able to do that, that's totally fine. You can just squeeze up. That's still, you'll feel it. You're still squeezing the butt to lift. And if you want to go one step further, you can always squeeze up and opposite tap, elbow to knee. So ready? We're going to squeeze it up. And if you want to tap and go down, that's one. Squeeze it up. That's two. Squeeze it up. Three. Squeeze it up. That's four. You got one more. Squeeze it up. That's five. Awesome. Take a breath. We're going to go down to our elbows. Elaine's going to be on her elbows. She's going to be doing bike legs, which is going to be right knee in, left leg out, and then opposite. And if you're following me, you can do full bicycles, bringing the elbow to the knee, elbow to the knee. So let's start with that right leg in and across. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, it's justifying a genocide, 2, romanticizing the theft, 1. Bloodshed that awesome. America, the land, release it out. Come to your back. Life, if you need support for your head, feel free to add a towel or a pillow or fold the mat. So Elaine is going to do just an upper body crunch. She's going to take her hands and she's going to reach the legs for that crunch. And I'm going to be doing more of a full sit-up, butterfly sit-up. So ready? Let's use those upper abs. For a one, control the down. For a two, breathe it out. Exhale for three. And four. Control both directions. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine, 10, awesome, hugging those knees, releasing the back, rock it out, ab work is done, we're going to do some stretching to finish this off, so straighten, put that left foot on the floor, hug that right knee in, and then reach that foot of the right leg to the ceiling. You can pull up the hamstring or the calf muscle to pull that right leg in. You can release, cross that right ankle over the left knee, and we're gonna push on that right inner thigh, winging out that bent leg. And then taking that right knee, we're gonna hug it across towards that left shoulder. And then open it up again, wing it out. And then you can reach through the legs to grab for that left leg hamstring or back of the leg to pull it in towards you. Release. Cross that right leg over the left leg, crossing at the knees. And we're gonna drop those knees to the left, opening up the arms in a T. And then we're going to take that right arm, we're going to reach it across over, connecting with that left hand, and then open it up, reach it over for two, open it up, reach it over for three, open it up, and then close it in, taking that right foot unconnected from the left leg. Grabbing for that right ankle or right foot. We're going to bring the right heel towards the right butt cheek to open up for the front of the right leg. So squeeze that butt forward. Squeeze that hip forward. Open up for the front of the right leg. release. Coming back to the middle. Hug both knees. Release that right foot to the floor. Pulling that left knee in. Straighten it to the ceiling. Pulling at the calf of the hamstring to pull it in a little deeper. Release it, taking that left foot, cross it over the right knee. Pushing on that left inner thigh, wing it away. Pull that outside hip. And then pulling that bent left knee towards your right shoulder. Hug it in, cross. And then open it up, pushing on that inner thigh again. Reach through the legs, grabbing for that right hamstring, right back of the leg. Pulling it towards you. Release, crossing at the knees, left over right, dropping the knees to the right. Twisting through that torso, opening the arms in a T. And then reach that left arm over, connecting the hands, and then back, open up. Reach that left arm over, open up. Reach that left arm over. Open up, breathe out. And then last one, we're gonna connect the hands, stay on that right side. Take that right hand, take that left hand, reaching for the left foot or ankle, releasing that top leg. And bring that heel towards your glute, towards your butt, and squeeze that butt forward to open up to the front of that left hip. Open up to the quad, the front of that left leg. And release. Coming back to the middle. Take a big hug of the knees. If you want to lift that chin up to your chest, make a bigger circle to hug it in. And then release. Safe way to come up. Roll over onto your right side, using that left hand to push you up. Thank you so much for joining. Thanks for working. Have a great rest of your weekend. Take care.